So in the last lecture, we have derived, we wrote down this expression N2 by N1. What is N2 and N1? N2 and N1 are the populations of level 2 and level 1 respectively, okay? And from Boltzmann's formula, from statistical mechanics, we derived this expression that N2 by N1 is e to the power of minus E2 minus E1 by KT, and E2 minus E1 is H nu, so E to the power of minus H nu by KT. Okay. Now, let us try to calculate what are the these numbers. How does this ratio of N2 by N1 look like if we consider a visible light emission? That means frequency of radiation is around 10 to the power 15 Hertz, and the Planck constant and Boltzmann constant have their values. And if I assume the room temperature to be of the order of 100 Kelvin or 300 Kelvin, then N2 by N1, if you calculate it from this formula, e to the power of minus H nu by KT, then it comes out to be e to the power of minus 100, okay, which is pretty low than 1, so which is much, much less than 1. So that means N2 is much, much less than N1 at room temperature for visible light emission and at thermodynamic equilibrium. What we want to create in this lecture, we want to create a lasing system. Lasing system means what? The emitted radiation has to be highly directional, highly monochromatic, highly coherent, etc., etc. Okay, and that property is only can be achieved if we can increase the number of stimulated emission, because in stimulated emission we have these properties that they are highly directional, they are highly monochromatic, and you can multiply the number of stimulated emissions, number of photons, by colliding them with the atoms. Okay, so we want to create a situation where stimulated emission dominates. But what we see in practical situation, we see that if your system is at thermodynamic equilibrium, then N2 is much, much less than N1. So you can understand that if N2 is much, much less than N1, that means number of stimulated emission will also be negligible. So if a photon of energy H nu approaches an atom, basically it will be the probability of that particular photon to be absorbed in that atom. That means the probability for a stimulated absorption to happen will be much, much larger than the probability of stimulated emission. Okay, so you understand that if we want to create a lasing system, we need to increase, we need to invert this situation, N2 less than, very, very less than N1. This situation must be inverted. That means we need to create a situation where N2 is much, much larger than N1. Okay, so that situation is called population inversion. That means we have to invert the population of level 1 and level 2, and this is done by a method that is called pumping. Okay, so we have this N2 greater than N1 situation can be created using a method called pumping. Okay, and also we have to understand another thing from this particular situation, that this population inversion thing that cannot be achieved if your system is at equilibrium, because at equilibrium, at thermodynamic equilibrium, the situation will always be like this. Okay, so somehow we need to bypass that thermodynamic equilibrium condition, or somehow we need to trick the system, or